Framer, Webflow, and Figma sites. Can't decide which platform is right for you? Well, in this video, we'll test each of these platforms against 5 key categories and rate them on how they perform in each of them, so that we can make some evidence-based decision on which tool is perfect fit for you. Hi, my name is Bilal, also known as Average Design Dude. I've delivered hundreds of web design projects and used all of these tools personally. I know you might prefer one tool over another, but trust me when I say this, you might not have the full picture. So this video is for everyone who wants to make the right choice. Here are the 5 categories that we're gonna rate them for. First, let's talk about the most important category, features and ease of use. Let's start with Framer. Framer takes an open canvas approach just like most design tools. This means you can drag and drop the elements in and move them around freely. There are alignment guides, snapping, just like any design tool. If you are a designer or used any open canvas software, everything will feel familiar and easy to use. Overall, the whole canvas experience is just flawless. The terminology is also simplified. For example, using frames instead of div blocks and layout instead of flexbox, it shows that this platform has been designed for everyone and not just for the people who understand HTML or CSS. Everything just feels approachable and easy to understand. Adding a hover or a press stay to a button or applying effect with a single click, everything feels very natural. CMS system is also quite straightforward. If we talk about features, Framer is packed with almost everything you can imagine. You have dynamic reusable components through variables, a large preset library of effects, or you can also create your own. You can even add page transitions and add beautiful text effects. Framer also has an option to create text and color styles to maintain consistency and easily switch between light and dark modes. Designing for different devices is also very seamless once you understand the basics. Framer also gives you the ability to make code components, which means the sky is the limit. You can code pretty much anything you want. The things people have built with code components are truly mind-blowing. It also offers CMS integration for things like blogs and project pages, making it much easier to manage content. There are pre-built components such as icon packs, some even have dual tone effects. You also have carousels, triggers, sliders, search components, and more, all ready to use. Framer even includes its own form builder, which is quite simple to use, but if you want to use third-party forms, Framer has got you covered. There are also some creative elements like responsive text, countdown timers, patterns, and more. On top of all this, Framer also offers a decent collection of third-party plugins that add functionality beyond what's built in. By the way, if you want to learn all about Framer, I have a premium Framer course that is now 100% free on my channel. You will learn everything about Framer in that course. Link is available in the description. Recently, Framer also introduced design pages, which means you can create unlimited mockup designs. These are not your web pages, just mockups, just like in Figma design. The best part, design pages are completely free in Framer. People are even saying Framer is trying to capture some of that Figma's market share. There's also a massive marketplace for components and ready-to-use templates, both paid and free, which is a big plus. So for both ease of use and features, Framer gets 8 out of 10 each. It's delightful to use and packed with features. Now, what about Figma sites? Figma sites is still in beta, so evaluating it right now isn't completely fair, but since it's available, we're gonna do it anyways. In terms of ease of use, Figma sites feels exactly like Figma design. It's also an open canvas where you can move things around freely. And because Figma design is such a mature design tool, designing in Figma sites feels just as easy. You can do pretty much everything, for example, creating complex shapes, adding patterns, and much more. It also uses same auto layout functionality as Figma sites that works perfectly for web design as it is essentially based on CSS flexbox. Now, if you don't know what an auto layout is, don't worry. Or if you want to learn anything about Figma design, I have a 100% free Figma course available on my channel. Link is in the description. If we talk about features, Figma sites come with some unique features like typing effects, scramble text effects, you have reveal effects, parallax effects, you can even use marquees, You can do such interesting hover effects like this one. But there is a huge problem. Many of these effects sometimes just don't work for no reason. Look at this. I have applied a reveal animation, but in preview, nothing happens. And some of these features like capping line height doesn't work, although it shows in the design, but in preview, all different story. Now Figma does offer component support, but again, there is this problem with components. For example, have a look at this project card. I have made it into a component. I added over variants and another variant where this was flipped. Now when I reuse this component in my page bunch of times and overridden the properties like colors and images, but see, now when I hover on this, it just doesn't work. So I have to make different components for each different card, which kind of destroys the whole idea. Similarly, you can't focus on a particular position of an image, for example, the face of this person, which is really needed for responsive design. It just feels like Figma is still not very well equipped for web design. There are no page transitions, CMS support is also missing, something they promised more than 6 months ago. There are no plugins available in Figma sites yet, which is kind of a shame because I like to use this plugin called Baseline to create my color palettes and typography, and then with a single click I can add them to my variables panel. You can even steal sizing system from popular design systems and copy them to your variables directly. There is a lot you can do for free in this plugin, but if you do go for a paid plan, which by the way is a very affordable price, then you can even create multiple collections and automatically build a variable system. This is extremely useful and pro designers use this system all the time. I have covered this variable system in this video on my channel. But shame, plugins are not available in Figma sites yet. Anyways, talking about Figma sites templates, there are a few available, but again, very basic templates, nothing fancy yet. With that said, for ease of use, Figma gets 6 out of 10, and for features, it gets 4 out of 10. Now let's talk about Webflow. Webflow is the most famous no-code web design tool, and for a good reason. First, let's talk about ease of use. Webflow isn't an open canvas. It uses more of a guided drag and drop layout builder approach. You can't move elements around freely or zoom out to get a bird's eye view of your page. You have to go into this panel to add layout boxes. If you want to add a text, again, go into the panel and add a text right from here. It seems that there are so many panels and it is quite frankly very confusing. The terminology is pure developer language. Divs, sections, flex boxes, class names, query selectors. If you don't already know HTML and CSS, you will find it very confusing. There is definitely a steep learning curve. I am both a designer and a programmer, and even with a strong understanding of HTML and CSS, I still found it difficult to navigate. There are also some frustrating limitations. For example, if I want to wrap two elements inside a stack or a flexbox, as Webflow calls it, I can't just select them and wrap them together. I have to manually add another flexbox and drag each element inside it. And the worst part is that you can't multi-select, so you have to move each item individually. This is quite embarrassing in my opinion. Adding animations or effects is also complicated. Yes, there are preset effects, but if you want to create a custom animation, you have to use this strange vertical timeline system. And that's coming from somebody like me who uses complex tools like After Effects. I tried creating the same hero design in Figma sites, Framer, and Webflow took me the longest by far. So yeah, Webflow is not an easy tool to use. In terms of features, Webflow does offer a lot. You can build components, add effects, manage CMS content, do localizations. There are plugins and even forms. It has a large template library. Basically, it has everything that Framer offers, except for some of the pre-designed components and text effects. But Webflow lacks that finesse. Even the templates don't have that wow factor. And I think I know why. Remember I said Webflow is the most popular tool? That's because it's been around for years. Framer, on the other hand, launched much more recently, and that gave Framer the advantage of learning from how modern web design has evolved. Webflow is just now trying to catch up, but it's difficult to introduce major updates without breaking the projects that have been around for years. So for ease of use, Webflow gets 5 out of 10, and for the features, Webflow gets 7 out of 10, not because it lacks features, but just using them is overly complicated. Next category that we're gonna rate for is how these tools are doing AI integration. Let's start with Figma Sites. Figma Sites has Figma Make, which helps you create components using generative AI. For example, you can draw an empty frame here. tell Figma Make to create an analog clock, and it does a pretty good job. Besides that, Figma also adds AI features like background removal, image generation, and boost resolution, all quite useful. So for AI integration, Figma sites get 7 out of 10. Now before we talk about AI integration in Framer and Webflow, I would like to thank today's sponsor, Luma AI. They are industry leading AI video platform, and they have just come up with this new model called Ray 3 with advanced reasoning and physics simulation, which means you can produce ultra quality videos that look supernatural and color graded to perfection. I specifically use Ray 3 model to create these cinematic videos to make my website hero sections more engaging. This helps me bring that wow factor to the web design, and it's all very straightforward. You can go to their website and just prompt whatever you want. So for example, for this video of the bear, the prompt was simple. Grizzly bear roars in the jungle and everything moves with the roar. And this is where it gets even better. You see all this motion blur, close-up shot? I didn't write it myself. So the thing is that when you write the prompt, you have this option here where you can pick the shot, camera angles, styles, and even lighting setups. This is by far the best thing I personally like about Luma AI, because let's be honest, we are not filmmakers and we don't exactly know how to prompt for a video. So this feature just makes it so much easier. Apart from this, you have some really cool features like making a looping video, which is really, really useful if you want to create videos for your web design projects. They also have this feature to add annotations to your shots to make it do whatever you want. Now, this was only possible on images so far, but Luma AI has made it possible in video too, which is kind of amazing. Now, you can also produce HDR content and also scale your shots up to 4K resolution. They are even adding AI audio feature. Listen to this. I didn't add this audio. It created it for me through AI. Man, sometimes I'm just blown away with the things that you can do with just a few clicks now. Anyways, check out Luma. I highly recommend trying it out. Link is in the description. Now let's get back to the topic and see how Framer is integrating AI. Framer AI integration is twofold. First, Wireframer, a generative AI that helps you quickly create wireframe layouts. It's good for getting a head start, though usually you will redesign it later. Second, we have Workshop plugin. This lets you create custom code components using AI. For example, you can ask it to build an analog clock component that shows the current time, then tweak its properties like time zone. If you know how to use it, you can create some amazing stuff. So for AI integration, Framer gets 6 out of 10. Now let's have a look at how Webflow does AI. Webflow has its own AI tool called AppGen AI. It's still new and in beta. I tried using it and couldn't figure it out. I'm sure that it cannot create reusable components for your page, so for now it's not very practical. So AI integration in Webflow gets 3 out of 10. Next category is pricing and value for money. Let's start with Figma sites. There is currently no separate pricing plan. Figma sites is available to anybody with a Figma professional plan. That's a huge plus. Since it's in beta, there are no bandwidth limits or restrictions yet. Though that will likely change once CMS and other features are added. So for now, I will give Figma 6 out of 10 based on its current value and pricing. Now let's talk about Framer pricing. Framer offers a free plan, which includes a lot like unlimited projects, free publishing to .framer.website domain. You can create up to 1000 pages, 10 CMS collections, free SSL, but there is a huge catch. 100 MB bandwidth limit and only 1000 visitors per month. This will expire in just a few days and you will be required to upgrade. And there is no custom domain in free plan. This is how they bring you into their expensive pricing ladder. So the first plan is the basic plan for £10 per month. In this plan, you can connect a custom domain. You get 30 pages, only one CMS collection with 1000 CMS items. You also get 10 GB bandwidth. And in this plan, you can also have 2 editors. And if you want to add more, you will have to pay £25 per editor. To be honest, this plan is pretty useless. Maybe you can make it work for a personal site or a portfolio, but for real projects, this is definitely not enough. Then there is a pro plan for £35 per month. It includes up to 150 pages, 10 CMS collections, 2500 collection items, 100 GB bandwidth. Most importantly, you get staging so that you can revert back to a previous version. Still, no analytics, but in this plan, you can add up to 10 editors. This plan, I think, is the most suitable for real projects, but it is quite expensive. Finally, you have a scale plan, which stands at £77 per month. It does give you more than most of the people will ever need. Plus, you do get the analytics, but it's insanely expensive. So for value for money, Framer gets 7 out of 10. It's powerful and easy to use, but the pricing is absurdly high. Now let's take a look at Webflow. It's much more affordable in comparison. The free plan limits you to 2 projects and 2 pages, but it includes 20 CMS collections with a 50 item limit. There is 1 GB bandwidth and 50 lifetime form submissions. You can publish the site on a free .webflow.io domain, but no custom domain. Upgrading to a paid plan gives you a lot. The basic plan is $18 per month and includes 150 pages. 10 GB bandwidth and unlimited form submissions. The only downside is there is no CMS in this plan. If you need CMS, you have to step up to a CMS plan. It is $29 per month, already cheaper than Framer's Pro plan. And it offers much more: 150 pages, 20 CMS collections, 2000 CMS items, 50 GB bandwidth, and more. The business plan takes that further with 40 CMS collections and 10,000 CMS items, but it's very expensive at $49 per month. So for value for money, Webflow gets 8 out of 10. It's complicated to use, but the pricing is much more affordable than Framer. Finally, let's talk about support and updates. Figma isn't doing great here. It's been months without any major updates to Figma sites. They're spread thin across so many products: Figma Design, FigJam, Figma Slides, Figma Make, Figma Buzz, and Figma Sites clearly isn't their top priority. The support team exists but takes days to respond. Support and updates for Figma sites get 4 out of 10. Framer, on the other hand, pushes frequent and meaningful updates. Not just small tweaks, but actual real feature additions. The Framer team also provides great tutorials and community is very active. The only downside is that direct customer support, just like Figma, takes days to respond. So for support and updates, Framer gets 7 out of 10. Webflow also releases regular updates, but these updates are kind of small and more cautious to avoid breaking older projects. The community is strong, there are tons of tutorials, and while I haven't personally needed to contact their support, I've heard it also takes some time. So Webflow gets 6 out of 10 for support and updates. Alright, so the total score for Framer comes to be 36 out of 50, Figma Sites 27 out of 50, and finally Webflow's total score is 29 out of 50. This puts Framer at number 1, Webflow at number 2, and Figma Sites at number 3. So that's it, Framer is the clear winner if you look at the numbers. But here's my recommendation. If you've got the budget, Framer is the ideal tool for you, no questions. Pay the big bucks and get the best in the industry. But if you are a bit tight on the money and are willing to spend some time learning the tool and willing to compromise a little bit on the features, then Webflow is the tool for you. With that said, I wouldn't recommend using Figma Sites at all, at least for now, because it's not clear what the future holds for it yet. And just wait for Figma Sites to get a few major updates and see how they tackle their pricing plans, and then we can revisit and evaluate it again. I hope this video makes it easier for you to pick the tool that is perfect for you. If you've liked this video, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel. I work really, really hard to bring quality content for my followers, and all I ask in return is your appreciation. That keeps me going. Thank you for watching, and like always, see you in the next one.